Oral submucous fibrosis, or OSMF, is a chronic condition characterized by abnormal collagen production. This leads to stiffening of the oral mucosa, specifically the cheeks, soft palate, lips, and tongue. It is caused by fibrous bands forming in the connective tissue underlying the mucosa. OSMF is primarily caused by betel nut and tobacco consumption, which releases compounds that trigger inflammation, tissue damage, and fibrosis. OSMF begins with initiation, wherein the mucosa becomes damaged and inflamed. This inflammation is counteracted with immune cells, which infiltrate the area. Following on from that, fibroblasts activate, whereby they produce collagen, which reduces the elasticity. This leads to advanced stages that present with complications involving the surrounding oral tissues. Frequent betel nut chewers, particularly adults from South Asian and Southeast Asian countries, have a greater risk of OSMF. This is due to prolonged compound exposure. Additionally, factors like ingredients, genetic susceptibility, sex, and oral hygiene contribute to the development and exacerbation of OSMF. With regards to ingredients, additional substances like tobacco exacerbate the betel nut's impact. With regards to genetic susceptibility, certain individuals are at a higher risk of developing OSMF. This is due to the immune response to the toxic compounds. The response to inflammation may also differ, as the immune system can exacerbate the tissue damage and fibroblast activity, and this is different for different people. Although both sexes are affected, males show higher prevalence from chewing habits and hormones. Poor oral hygiene accentuates the compound effects and accelerates the tissue damage. OSMF is classed into four stages to assess the severity. Stage 1 demonstrates mild signs and symptoms with poorly defined white lesions and slight stiffness in the cheeks, lips, and tongue. Symptoms include a burning sensation upon eating spicy foods. Stage 2 involves reduced opening capacity with well-defined white patches present. Eating spicy food remains challenging from the burning sensation continuing. Stage 3 includes locked jaw, presenting with a significant reduction in mouth opening. Speaking, eating, and oral hygiene maintenance present with difficulty. Extensive white patches also cover large areas of the oral cavity. Stage 4 involves restricted mouth opening to only a few millimeters, with incredible discomfort upon swallowing. Extensive scarring leads to significant changes in the appearance and texture of the mucosa. Diagnosis includes understanding risk factors, symptoms, and the identifying clinical signs. This is achieved through a detailed history and clinical examination. Measuring mouth opening is critical for understanding the severity of the condition. Additional assessments involve biopsies, imaging, and oral cancer risk assessments, particularly if tobacco accompanies betel nut consumption. These are especially important as OSMF has a malignant transformation rate of 1%. While OSMF has no cure, progression can be slowed with cessation of betel nut consumption. In addition, dietary changes like avoiding spicy foods and instead opting for a soft diet can help. Anti-inflammatory medications can reduce the inflammation and slow the tissue damage. Oral hygiene should generally be maintained to prevent secondary conditions like infections. To summarize, OSMF results from betel nut consumption with increased collagen deposition, reducing the elasticity of the oral mucosa. This stiffens the tissues and reduces the mouth opening with swallowing challenges present. Diagnosis involves history taking, examination, and confirmation tests. And management usually aims at eliminating the betel nut consumption and symptom relief with avoidance of spicy foods.